Hello everybody, and welcome back to Fallout 4 Melee Only. So for the time being, I'm going to be not in my power armor. Blimey. Okay, so I'd say that Diamond City is a little far away to do right now. So the only other thing that I can do is to make my way over to Ten Pines Bluff. And I think it's marginally safer if I go there via the Museum of Freedom rather than the Red Rocket truck stop. Also, between the last stream and this one, I leveled up by doing a bit of crafting. So let's have a look. Rooted isn't going to be as useful until I start relying on Blitz more. I'm also not doing that many sneak attacks right now, so Ninja isn't that useful just yet. Although these things say that it makes men easier to pacify, I've heard that due to a bug it makes it harder. I don't know if Bethesda has fixed that, but let's go. Have I done big leagues? I haven't done big leagues. So I can do big leagues or sneak. I mean, no longer triggering floor-based traps is going to be really good. But I'm going to go with big leagues. That one requires level 7. Really good. Level 2 requires level 13. And rank 2 requires, level 2 requires level 16. Once I start to have more settlements, then it'll be a good idea to start getting this up to Charisma 6. But since I'm not going to be using many settlements, that's not going to be as necessary. Oh yeah, I was going to fast travel. Also, since I'm not really going to be getting all of the settlements, or trying to max out the settlements. Oh, the death claw is still here. Yep, okay. I'm also going to quick save right here, just to save the loading screen. Okay, so probably been in here. Yeah. Oh, and now we have Chem's Vendor.
Hey there, sister. You looking for Chem's?
I'll take a look, sure.
Let me know if you see anything you like.
So he just literally just got Chem's. Well, I hope you don't mind if I pick up this can, and also this toolbox. Okay. I think for right now I'll want to sneak there. What's that? I think, yeah, that's Starlight Drive-In over there. I forget what that is, but I'll probably want to skirt around it. Now that there is, oh, this is, whatchamacallit? Thicket Excavations. I don't remember whether coming across he immediately gets you any enemies, but first time you come here, the guy is non-hostile. Okay. Yeah, I think it's only Sully that's here. We've got a tattoo. He's got a tibia for some reason. It's always funny when a non-hostile has a piece of bone in their storage. Just a little wrench, and that's the first sledgehammer and pipe wrench.
Unless you're gonna pitch in here, keep it busy.
Okay. Duct tape, cram, jet, beer bottle. I think that's everything. Yeah. Okay, and then there's one last building, and then you've got over there, I mean over there somewhere is a junkyard with a sentry bot and a holotape and stuff, cake pan, dirty water, combination wrench, cap stash. There you go.
Yes.
For the time being, picking up the food would be useful. This is also one of the harder novice locks to crack. There we go.
Got it.
Okay. So yeah, that air base Olivia is where now I'm coming close to Tempine's Bluff. That's where you get a locket. Should probably go through here. Apparently I can... Yeah, okay. So I can go through here and tag things for search without having to go and tag them in a crafting area. I'm going to tag that, I'm going to tag that, I'm going to tag that. Okay. I should probably also tag oil once I find it. But yeah, even though I'm not planning on siding with the I didn't side with the Minutemen in my casual playthrough in terms of completing the story. So that's a wild mongrel. And I don't even need to go near them, which is great. Granted, I could probably sprint the remaining distance and then have the settlers take care of. Take care of them, but now we're here. And if I remember right, the people here want me to get a locket from Olivia. At least that's what they wanted. The first time I played this. Okay. Hello. Apparently they want you to do randomly different things.
We don't need any more trouble or anything. It's okay. I'm with the Minutemen.
So sometimes it's
Minutemen?
Olivia, sometimes it's Corvega, sometimes it's Walden Pond.
Most people don't put much stock in Minutemen. Bad business.
Well, we're back.
The Minutemen, from the ground up. We are the good guys again. Glad to hear it. No question, things have been worse since the Minutemen fell to pieces. There's a raider gang that's been giving us trouble for weeks. Stealing food and supplies, threatening to kill us all if we don't come up. We know where they're coming from, but we can't go up against the gang.
Okay. Ah, so they want me to do Corvega.
Okay.
What's that sound? So yeah, oh, potatoes, that's probably an even better reward. And now when I get back, I can craft up some adhesive. I mean, I should, after planting these, of course, but yeah. Okay. I should probably save after fast traveling or not before. So yeah, Corvega assembly plant is around here. Easiest way to get it is probably via Drumlin Diner. But I may as well take the take the other person's quest for Station Olivia. So apparently like Preston has, I should probably scrap that. Okay. That's slow at 64. I can get this up to 96. But everything here requires rank 2 things. So that's 67. And when I get to once I get to whatchamacallit, Diamond City. Arturo sells an electrified, serrated Chinese officer sword. So I can purchase that, take that modification off, glue it onto this, and then this will now have that mod. Which means that by doing that, I can get the electrified serrated blade without rank 3 blacksmith, rank 1 science, of which rank 1 science is probably the bigger thing, the bigger whatchamacallit. Block, I guess. Okay, so I can do limb damage or armor piercing. But either way, it would do less damage than this. But this does bleed. Which means that limb damage is probably better. Like last time, I'm going to call this the castrator. And I'm going to call this, what am I going to call it? I mean, you use one of these, in Grand Theft Auto 5 to break someone's knee or wrist, depending on chance. So I don't want to call it the kneecapper because that's the I think that's the suffix of the special pipe wrench Big Jim. So I'm going to call this the handicapper. Okay. So that's basically a secondary That's a secondary heavy weapon. Oops. I want to have that out. I'm going to set this as a secondary medium weapon. Did I scrap the armor workbench? No, I think it's out here. Yeah. Oh, there's a hard hat. I'm already wearing a hard hat, but okay. In a metal bucket. Combination wrench. What's this? Sure. So yeah, once I once I have Psycho and Jet, it's beneficial to add the Jet to the Psycho. Ooh. I guess that doesn't really have that much purpose right now. Stampede, purified water. Purified water. Don't think it shows up here, but I mean, it is possible to tag junk for this. Oh. Gotcha. And another blowfly gland. Okay. Yeah, you tend to get blowflies around there. And this settlement tends to have a bunch of things attacking it, but that's Abernethy Farm. Let's get some more potatoes. And once I have enough Okay. What's a pussycat? So yeah, at this point I easily have enough stuff here such that I'll like I'll find it.
I'll get that locket back for you.
Good. Connie feels like it's hot in the air. I don't think she'll rest easy.
Okay. So I think this quest always takes you to Station Olivia. And all this stuff is stealing. I could, if I wanted to, just close the door and rob them blind, but I don't really need to do that. Ooh. Okay. Right. So yeah, even though I don't need to do either of these quests, it's still going to be good for the experience and for the general loot that I would find. Plus, Corvega Assembly Plant is close to the point where you meet the Brotherhood, right over here. So it'd also be advantageous to obtain this point to get it. But I think Station Olivia is a little easier, so I'm going to go there first. Did I miss any loot in here? It doesn't look like it. Okay. What? Oh. Okay. You can keep that pipe pistol. Didn't I just go here? could swear I'd just, yeah, you know, and that was
nice.
It's not supposed to. Yeah, I've been here because that's empty and okay then. So apparently this area respawns really quickly. Yeah, there's even more of these. I'll leave your weapons. How's that, Mr. Guy? Okay. Oh, what's detecting me? I'm going to quick save right here. The raider up there has already been killed. Yeah, so he's right over there. Wow, this is going really well. Oh my god. So, one of those mole rats has a bomb attached to it. Whoop! Yeah. So, by going after those bloat flies, yeah, it just saved me a lot of trouble. I'd probably have to use VATS, because VATS makes you highly resistant to damage. So, yeah. Took out the attack dog. It's got a collar. I'm don't know if I can modify that, but it does have leather on it, so I probably should take it regardless. Tibia 38. Baseball glove. Okay. I'll leave the dog food. And I don't think there's anything over here. Nope. Dog meat. There we go. Okay. I don't know where the bloat flies went to, but there's a rad stag doe. Okay. You know what? You know, oh, there we go. There's one bloat fly. But one thing that would be useful would be the ability to... There's another piece of mole rat. Like how that sort of highlights living people. It'd be useful if there was some like a perk that highlights corpses, because it can be, there's many circumstances where it's quite difficult to notice a Scribe the radar leathers in here. Okay. I think the corpse over here also had leather stuff. So I should probably pick it up. I think that's cloth and that's steel. Oh well. Oh! Oh, hello. Thanks, dog meat. Okay. Now I did autosave there, but I think, like with fast traveling, reloading will put me on the other side of the load zone. So it's a good idea to can't pick up these bones. Excellent. I can do without an extinguisher. Radex. Purified water, blowtorch. I can do without the wood. Metal bucket. Okay, that's everything in this room. That room has a bunch of stuff in it, but I need to go to there. Should probably have my weapon out. So there's an attack dog. Sometimes a dude in here. Seems like there isn't. I'll pick up the plunger. What else? Left arm bones, that and that. Uh-oh. Gotcha! Ooh! Oh! Thanks, doggy! Ooh! That's that guy. Made of leathers. Okay. Some more red X. Wait, did I miss something? Oh, a folder. Don't need that. Okay. I think the angle's actually around here. Bounce there. There we go. Buff out mentats and that. Oh, and duct tape. And a gear. Think that, yeah, adjustable wrench is a gear. Okay. Probably should tag acid because for the time being, acid is going to be relatively hard to come by. Oh, I definitely need crystal. Actually, I probably don't because I'm not using energy weapons. I don't need gold. Ah, here we go. Some oil. Okay, there we go. It's quiet. Too quiet. Ooh. That's went well. What's in here? Ooh, give me the coffee cup, thank you. Okay. Ooh, hot plate. The broom. I think a desk over there has fancy lad snack cakes. I can do without that. Scalpel. Ah, it's over here. Lighter. I think that terminal is just Oh fuck. Probably destroyed that guy. Here we go. Okay. Ah, Akak. 5mm, that. I don't think the Drifter outfit has leather in it. I think it's technically cloth. So I'm not going to pick it up. Going to take the minigun. And I'm going to drop it. And that should give me its ammo. Yeah, now I have 591 rather than 100. Road leathers. I think that's leather. Okay. Upper skull. Okay, I've dealt with you. Whoop. Okay. Over there, I've dealt with you. Probably don't really need to bother with the overdue books since it's not. Army helmet. So hard hat is 4 and that's 10. Okay. So jewel tray, teddy bear, aluminium. Ooh, fuse. Okay. I think one of these things, one of these barrels apparently has mole rat teeth on it, but I don't think it's, I seem to remember it being here, but I, yeah. Oh, a noodle bowl, a noodle cup. Do without that. Aluminium can. Okay. Desk fan. Whoop. We've got Heads and Jets and Nuka Cola. Can I pick this up? Can I? There we go. Let's see. Oh, it's in the bin. Okay. So there's an upper skull and another upper skull. Okay. Oh, the screwdriver fell. So locket, that's for those people. Bobby pin, jet, duct tape and terps. So I'm going to quick save right here after getting that. There we go. Come on. There we go. Oh. So the legendary Red Roach came out. Huh? Okay. Have I gotten all the Red Roach meat? Seems to be. Okay. There we go.
Sweet.
Okay. That's not. For some reason, some of those lanterns you can't actually pick up at all. Oh, some stim packs. Oh. Okay, first time playing, this was the legendary Red Roach, but now the other one was. Okay. Intel room key, which will get me to that area. And the only other thing in this room is some ammo and a Radaway over there. But I don't really want to soak up all those rads. Let's see. Assassin's leather left arm. My current left arm is 5/5. Raider. Yeah, I think having that is gonna be more beneficial. So, I mean, I guess that's fortunate. The very first piece of a broom. What's my weight like? Okay, I'm probably. Getting close to being overweighted. So, terminal, how about a key? Oop, there we go. With dish rag. Hmm. I'm going to pick up the other junk first, and then if I have extra room, if I have extra room, then mini nuke and that, and a permanently more difficult of the decks while sneaking. Sure, I'll take those. They should... Yeah. They all scrap down to some useful components. Okay. Yeah, and I can't carry anymore. Okay. So, aside from getting caught, I should probably eat some food actually. No, there's a bed, I can use a bed. Aside from getting caught, could also scrap that because, oh, it has leather. I guess that's, that leather comes out of the pocketed mod. Okay. Okay. And that's full health. Okay.
I've got that locket back for you.
You serious? That's great news.
Oh, am I gonna level up? Hey! Okay. I could go for more melee damage. But for the most part, I had enough damage in this, so... I'd say having more sneak will be beneficial. Now I do plan on eventually retaking the castle, and that's because I need to do some scrapping. Be right back. You know, I think I might also have stuff to cook, but... Do you not have an armor workbench? Really? I can't build one. What's over here? Yeah, I don't think you have an armor workbench. Or a weapons workbench, I guess. Actually, I don't need a workbench to scrap the weapons. I can just drop them in that, and that, and that. Okay. Yeah, so raider leathers are leather, and road leathers are leather. Okay. We'll take it. Tatoes, alarm clock, aluminium, fertilizer, leather, military ammo bag, nuclear material, surgical tray, and you can heat the steel. Actually, hold on. I should be wearing my charisma gear. Yes. Okay. You can take the frag mine, the Molotovs. That's my gear. Sort of val, sort of weight. That's oil. Take the broom, the clean broom, that. I'll keep the military ammo bag because ballistic fiber is hard to come by. But since I won't be doing that railroad quest, I don't think I'll need it. But you never know. I'll keep the circuitry. You can take the hammers. Apparel. That's leather. Okay. And then I'll just take everything here that's worth taking. You've got fusion cells. Hey-o. Okay, let's see what's over here. Use oil can. Coffee cup. Whoop. I'll let you keep the Molotovs. Aluminium. Okay. And I believe that's all the stuff. Okay. Going to quick save, head over into here. Oh, there's a hub flower. Two of them, in fact. Okay. Let's see. Got... Okay. 10 mil rounds, a hot plate. Stimpak purified water. Dirty Australian cigarette. Yeah, so what I could do is run around this and scrap everything. But it doesn't seem like there's really that much need to do so. I mean, I guess I could go and turn their melons into potatoes, but aside from something like that, it should be all fine. Grilled rad roach, all that chunks. Okay. So yeah, since I'm not really going to be building here, I'm fine to head back to the sanctuary. But yeah, a while ago I was talking about Ten Pines Bluff. So that's a lot better. I can be fine without doing anything there. Come on, there we go. Probably switch over to my good gear. Okay. Dog meat. So, I think you can wear the welding goggles. Yep, okay. Which means I can scrap the leather right arm. Okay. Yeah, deep pocketed requires armor too. So I'll make that pocketed. I think this is the only thing that's not pocketed. And I'd rather have it be pocketed. Guess I could do shadowed. Yeah, I don't know why I made this alloyed. Maybe because I didn't have any. I don't know. But that should be shadowed. Okay. So Raider gear can't be shadowed. But the other stuff can. Okay.
Seems to be growing well.
I don't really need that much. I'll do up those. Then I'll store them. Okay. Resources, food. So there's the carrots, melon, root fruit, razor grain. Do I want to plant another razor grain? I think I will. And then I definitely want to plant some potatoes. I'll plant them over here. I probably actually don't have enough mute fruit to be able to Okay. I'll take that. These will have grown. So that's the mute fruit. Yeah, I definitely don't have enough corn or mute fruit to be able to build some starch. Okay. So, to go over my crops, the potatoes, mute fruit, and corn are there to create vegetable starch. The carrots are there to create. They're going to here. It's not grape mentats. Orange mentats. I guess I could also. Berry mentats aren't really that good because tar berries are hard to come by. Grape mentats are actually pretty good because I'd be able to. So yeah, if grape mentats are more useful to me than orange mentats. Oh, I can make a psycho. Some jet. Buff jet, okay. So there's that. That. Acid is used in the other thing, Medex. If great mentats are so good, I probably want to not do this so that I can save the Abraxo cleaner for making mentats. Once I have a big enough adhesive farm, I'll have enough mute fruit so that this is a reasonable usage for Nuka-Cola. That's basically the only usage for Red Scorpion Stingers, so if I ever find one, that's where it would be good for. Right now silver is probably too rare to do this. And Medex. I don't know. I wonder if there would be a challenge. Idea. Where something like using vegetable soup and baked bloatfly I guess these two. The weirdest commented that these remove, even though these say they remove 50 points, they actually remove 5. But oh. May as well do that though. Yeah, so I wonder what challenge would have vegetable soup and bloatfly meat be useful for crossing the glowing sea? Guess I may as well head over to Drumlin Diner. I do have a lot of ammunition to sell. But there might be raiders here. Yep. Oh. There we go. I think these guys are I'm pretty sure NPCs like Trash Can Carla and the other person. Oh, there we go. Ooh. I'm pretty sure those are a sort of I'm still wearing the glasses. Okay. So I'll come to you first.
Back again. Time to do business.
Sure thing.
A few minutes to browse. Here's what I got.
So since I have the friend thing, the whatchamacallit, the friend perk or something like that. Yeah, so that's gotten over. So you have a pipe wrench and a walking cane. Probably take these last. That's expensive. I'll happily take those. Take your Abraxo. Don't really need nuclear material just yet. At least not enough to justify spending that much on it. I'll take that so that I can build the thing. Probably won't buy that. I already have enough from the decanter. Huh. So the rat scorpion stinger is technically junk. Okay. I wonder if the game, when it like uses items when you say build stuff, I wonder if it prioritizes not using ingredients that can be used for like other things, like the bloatfly gland for the person, or the red scorpion stinger for the syringe ammo. Okay. Don't need any ammo. obviously. Yeah, I'll take those, because I can afford it. There we go. And the buff out is really expensive, so that doesn't help. Nine. There we go. Okay. So I need to sell six. There we go. Okay. Hello. Yeah, I don't really have anything here to sell. I mean, I guess there's that, if only because it's the sort of thing that I would never use. V5, fusion cell, mini nuke, shotgun shell. Okay. Machete. I already have a machete. I think those might be stuff that I've already sold to you. Misc. Okay. I'll keep the fusion core because it's useful for stuff. So I'll head back to Sanctuary. And so and it's funny that, like, right then, Trudy commented that she was happy to see Wolfgang dead, but in my first playthrough I settled it such that they both survived, should probably put on the gear before actually, that's 12 and 9, and that's 3 and 10. Six and six, 2 and 5. That's it, actually. Yeah, pocketed, shadowed. My My current right left arm is legendary. My current right arm is metal, so I can scrap both of those. So yeah, 3 and 10 is better energy than 12 and 9, but that's better ballistic. And I do tend to get more ballistic damage than that sort of damage. The only difference is that making that shadowed would be better. And it's cloth, okay. Okay. Pocketed, and I wanted to be shadowed. So that's pocketed, and all of these are pocketed. Okay. Should also put that on. I've done everything there. I might have a more fertilizer to, yeah. Guess I had a bunch of fertilizer from the other places as well. Take the razor grain. So a lot of that is, but some of these have people running them, but they do tend to do the things. So I'll set up a generator. I'll put it up there. And I'll build a recruitment radio beacon, of which I already had enough crystal to make. So that's great. And it's not clipping. Okay. The weirdest likes to put both of these in, or like on top of something. But my preference is to put this on the ground and then this up high, because otherwise what tends to happen is the wire will clip through one of these dishes. So that will get settlers to come in. And then so sales will come in, they'll take care of the food, and I will get a bunch of stuff. No hostiles? No hostiles, okay. I wonder if it would be a good point, a good idea to take that. One time, I spotted, like, this was off camera, but I was over at that area, and the way that I set up that area was I had some automated turrets at the entrance, and a legendary red scorpion spawned. It spawned outside the front. And I don't quite remember what the legendary drop was. Oh. I'll take the quantum, sure. Oh. Mentats. I'm going to go over this way. Because I cannot take out those bloodbugs. Okay. What's in here? Oh. Hello. Alright then. Yeah. So for some reason looking through a person's inventory doesn't make them hostile. Which no, it seems like, for most people, rifling through their stuff in their pockets, like, wiggling around through their pockets, would probably make them pretty hostile. This seems like ghoul territory. I mean, there's ghouls in another derailed train area, but... Oh, and there's the Corvega assembly plant, I think. Yeah, I think that's it. Oh, that's birds. Okay. So in this area, I only need to kill Jared for it to count as complete. Now, I guess well, there might be a legendary in here. Better quick save me home beforehand, but this building is a Red Roach area. Yeah, red roach. Okay. Ushanka hat. Oh! Do I want the Ushanka hat? Sure. Actually, to be perfectly honest, I probably don't need... That's another red roach. I think one of these has the potential to be legendary. But I don't think any of them was. Were. Yep, I think they were all normal. Okay. So last time I entered Corvega through the front door and there was quite a bit of difficulty had. So... Oh, I think it's on the other side. Go. So if I listen to this long enough, I'll find there we go. Oh, okay. So that'll send me to over there where I'll be able to find the thing. So yeah, I think if I go around here, I'll be able to find the sneaky entrance. I think it's through here. Although, to be perfectly honest, I don't actually know where it is. So... let's hope I can find it. Ooh! Ooh! Sure. Ah, I remember this. Military fatigues. Nothing in the sinks. Okay. Now I think the military fatigues are better. That's 5 and 0. Oh, it actually isn't. I mean, it gives me more agility, but... it would be better if I were going... if I were to go for ballistic weave, though. Okay. Yeah, there. There's a radio all the way up there. So it's either on this side of the road or that side. Might be this side actually. I seem to recall it being next to a body of water. So there's a little pool over there, and I've gone past. Oh, there's frag mines. So yeah, there's two frag mines over there. Okay, a master safe. Oh, okay. So yeah, sneak two would have let me walk over those mines without them. Without them activating. Okay. Maybe it's this side of the thing. Yeah, I can't really find where it is, so I think I'll just have to go in through a main entrance. I probably don't need to go in through the front door, but there's always a side door. So that's the location proc. I should probably stop looking for the secret entrance. So there's a raider. And a quick save. Head over there. Raider scum. Probably have them get closer. Really? I mean, I certainly can't blitz you from here. Yep. Come over here. There we go. Can't get you from here. Come on. Gotcha. Okay. Take that, I'll take that. I'll take that. Sure. And a tar berry. Sure. Whoop. That I can hock. Okay, so I'm gonna head into here. Yep. Gotcha. Oh, it's just that guy. Yeah, I'm gonna. Oop. If I hide in here, they might. Oop, there's another guy coming. Oop. Okay. There's another guy coming. Oop. He's coming around, but other than that. Holy fuck. Around there, it's coming across. Okay. The fuck? I need to take some Stimpex. I had no idea my health was going to be that low. And I'm going to a quick save, and I'm gonna think I'm losing them. But if I get Molotovs again, I'll have to reload and flee. Oh, there we go. Okay. Oh. Sweet! I lost them. Now I think that door over here is chained. Oop. Yeah. Oh, that's a Lexington proc. Okay. There we go. If I'm in danger, then the people that I'm in danger from tends to be okay. Good boy. Okay. A little too bright. Okay. Eventually I'll be able to get to you. Rather than I can load that and save having some stim packs. Oh. Could use dog meats to kill them. I wonder if the army fatigues are stealthier than the other stuff. Okay. Oh yeah. Move the fuck. I mean, dog mate's taking care of it. Now out of the way, because they seem to be fond of Molotovs. This dude's over here. Oop. That could have gone bad. And there's these two. I need to take a jet jaw. Need some stim packs. Ooh. I need to get out of the way. Come on, get up. Probably a good time as any to have a Molotov chucked at me. Still nobody over that way. Okay, seems like I'm in a good position. Oh. We'll see about that. Oh. Oh, he all of a sudden lost me. Which is alright, I don't mind. Ooh. Okay. Stimpak. That'll be a good repayment. Ooh. Yeah, any lower end. I'll probably end up aggroing that, whatchamacallit. Oh, that was a Molotov. Yeah, I think this area has been emptied otherwise. Yeah, even though that light is making a big noise. Seems like nobody's aggroed. I mean, I can't destroy those lights. Probably take iron as well. Definitely seems like a good idea to do, because I definitely don't want to be low on iron. There we go. Oh, you didn't even notice me. Okay. There we go.
Yes.
Don't need either of those. There we go. That'll get me some extra health. There's some leather. Can I take this? No. Okay. I think this area is the conveyor belts with the steel, and the other area is the conveyor belts with the aluminium. So that's roughly where I want to be. Gonna quick save and then I'm just gonna blast in, I guess. Okay, this is a good point. Boom. Okay. Yeah, it doesn't do that much damage to me. Okay. Okay. That might have actually been related to, whatchamacallit. Okay. Okay. Here we go. So those things I can sell. Okay. These coolant caps are a good source of aluminium. Was there a dude down here? I mean, probably not otherwise. Oh, I think I skipped. Yeah. I skipped these guys because they were a little too close. There's a wrench. Okay. And there's the area that takes you to what's his name? Okay. So I'm gonna have a small intermission right now. I'm gonna have a short break, and I will be back in no more than half an hour. So I will see everybody then.